Hello, I am the Mad West Cowboy, back again with Ark. This time it's not Scorched Earth because due to the patch notes that have just been downloaded, you can now actually play Ragnarok on solo player. So here it is. To anybody who was following the Scorched Earth series, I apologize, but I've been waiting to get on solo player Ragnarok for a long time. I mean, I've been playing it multiplayer with a couple of friends online on stream every night on Twitch. So if you'd like to see what the multiplayer aspect's like, do please follow the stream at Mild West Cowboy. But yeah, it's been fun playing with other people, but I do like playing on my own occasionally. Which is what I'm more used to. So, as usual, I'm just grabbing up the usual basics, some wood, some stone, grab some thatch. So I should be able to make a pick. Oh, I gained, because it is a solo player server, you can actually tweak the gather rates and the XP rates and things like that, which is what I've done. Because if you've tried playing our Ragnarok on the official servers, it is brutal. I mean, I'm not brilliant at the game by any means at all. I enjoy it, which is why I play it. But I was getting destroyed so many times. It stopped becoming fun. And for me, when you're gaming, if you're not having fun, then it's not really worth playing. I mean, we have moved over to a slightly friendlier server. It was a player run server. So yeah, that has made things taken some of the heat off it. Isn't in the stream, but yeah, now here I am on Ragnarok solo player. I don't know. I don't want to keep making them. I'm not sure what's they've done there. They've somehow I managed to put the learning skill into my hotbar instead of an actual pickaxe. I've got what do I need? What do I need? Thatch, more thatch. I should dump some of the weight. I don't need them. I got XP for building them, but I don't really need them. I'll follow this ridge around. Now I am sort of covering similar ground to the places I've seen on Ragnarok already. This is just a temporary measure whilst I get my level up and we can explore for somewhere deeper into the interior or around a different part of the coast. So that should get me. Yeah, it's got me that. I'll get one of. Well, I'll get more than one of those because they break so easily. A couple of those, and I'll put more points into Fortitude. Yeah, on Ragnarok, it gets very cold. So yeah, Fortitude, unfortunately, is one of the, I found one of the priorities for putting your skill points into. What can I make now? Water skins. I'm going to need 4 hide. So just dump. I'm not. I can always collect more metal at a later date. Don't really need all that. Can I move? Yeah. So So I'll just quickly equip those into the hot bar. Hatchets into slot 3. Torch. It's always helpful to if you have like a hot bar sort of pattern where you, or you only ever have one item equipped in that particular slot, so that when you are being chased and or in a rush, you can find the right piece of equipment just by just without thinking about it. You automatically know, oh, it's in. Oh, there's one of the newly added things in Ark. These are beached whales. You can harvest them and get lots of spoiled meat. Now, I'm not sure how long that will last there, because I don't know if it's does ha it doesn't show it has a spoil timer. But what do I need? Cooking stone wood. That's easy enough. I might just quickly build a fire here, and then harvest that once I've got a mortar and pestle set up. I'll just quickly apply that to fortitude once again. Mortar and pestle learned, thatch platform learned. So that's good. I can head back over here. I'll just quickly build a thatch platform so that I can place a mortar and pestle on it. And then with the spoiled meat from that whale, I can actually put that in the mortar and pestle. And when actually when I have to learn the engram for it, but when I do, I can make narcotics. What do I need? 15 hide. Right. Oh, compies, I'll do. Level 47. Oh, spear broke. If this were, well, if I managed to kill all these without dying, which is no guarantee, then I should have a hide, and I should actually have meat as well. Yep, I've got 9 more raw meat. 19. 47 raw meat and 32 hide. Ah, that's why I like single play. You can have the settings a bit more convenient for you. Let me see about a fire, because I have not made one of those yet. Stone. Just quickly. Bash rocks. Make well, I have fuel, so I can make the fire, cook the meat. Just quickly use thatch rather than the wood. I've only got the one wood, and that should be good. Right, I need clothes. I'll just harvest more fiber, and hopefully that will give me enough points to learn clothes or something. before I start? I mean, I've got plenty of berries on me. I've been subsisting on berries on the stream because on official servers, meat was a bit hard to get hold of. Well, easy meat was hard to get hold of. So, I can make narcotics now, and I can make spark powder, which will be very, very helpful. So, that should have cooked some. Yeah. Whack that in the hot bar. And now I'll harvest this. That's a lot of spoiled meat I'm getting from there, and I'm getting a decent amount of hide and a really nice amount of keratin and some oil. It's a little bonus. There we go. I just got something ridiculous like 782 spoiled meat. So I am over encumbered, but luckily I got a level as well. So just add that there. I need. I'm going to need to learn s hide sleeping bag. Before and a bed. Dump that. I could pick it up after, but I can move just. Oh, did I didn't build the mortar and pestle, did I? Because I didn't have the hide. It's not a problem anymore, I don't think. Stone. Okay. And I still can't move. What can I dump? Another 0.8. Don't need the metal at the moment. There's another stone. See, once I can get the stone, then I'll seriously reduce the weight I'm carrying because I'll be able to make the mortar and pestle. Like so. Right. So, get that over here. I'll place it next to the fire so if it does turn night time, I can actually see what's going on. There we go, and whack that all in there. And I'll have to go out and collect some more, but I'll just quickly grab some more meat and guess about crafting, collecting. Sorry, I need to get more, quite a lot more berries. T3 is not a bad start. There we go. I'll just stick the oil in there for the time being. Bolas, they're going to be very helpful. They always are. And I've used too many points. I do know where there is a source of crystal. It's just might take a while for me to get there. gained another level. It's partly because I'm standing right next to the molten pestle as it's working away. I'll get the proper bed. Oh, stone arrows, I'll need those. A bow. Oh, I need to learn the slingshot first, and I'll just use a point. Okay, level 42. That's quite a big chap. Right, it is daylight, as you can see. I've made some more narcotics. I can't remember off the top of my head how many it was. I've got 30 narcotics. I've still got lots and lots of spoiled meat. But now I'm running out of narco berries. So I think the plan is I'll try and gather a few more. But what I want to do is knock out a parasaur. I've learned how to make the parasaur saddle. So if I can find a low enough level one and knock it out with a club, then that will give me the opportunity. I'll use the narcotics I've got and whatever berries I've gathered to tame up that, and then I can saddle it and use it to harvest more narco berries to make more narcotics. Go, that's giving us another 14, which is lovely. Do I have enough points to learn the club? Because I haven't. Oh, I can use a slingshot. I'll use a slingshot instead. Water would be nice. And thinking about it, as a kindly reminder, I can make water skins. There we go. Made three, so I should be able to get a little bit further away inland, away from water sources, without struggling too much. And just stick that last one in. Fill them all up. Quickly. Add more points into fortitude. Level 13. I need to learn a ramp. What I'm waiting for is level 16 when I can learn how to make a raft. Because that would give me the opportunity to explore a bit of the coastline without actually putting myself in serious danger, because I could set up a, I could just pull up away from the sh a little offshore, so nothing can swim out to attack me. I haven't got a slingshot yet though, so let me just make that. That'll do, and I'll need ammunition for that in the form of stones. Switch over to the hatchets and just, I'm not too sure how many stone I'll eat, so maybe 60 is enough. That should be okay. I can move-ish. And if I just creep up to the parasaur, it might not spook. Wish me luck. I try for headshots. And I hope I can knock it out before the polar breaks. Oh, no, it didn't. I was hoping you'd get stuck up against the trike then and pause. But got you again. Haha. I like the colour of him. Oh. Alright, scratch that one. It's a nice idea, but it didn't work. Do I try for something bigger or smaller? Maybe I should learn the club. Maybe it's less damaging. Maybe the stones were a bit too tough. Sure. It does mean that I can dump that out of the inventory and swap that over. And we can try again. If there were any power source here. But don't seem to be at the moment. What I could do in the meantime is, oh, I could have used that stone I just dropped rather than be wasteful. Oh, that wasn't that. There's I can't see the package of stone I dropped. Never mind. I can always get more. Hatchets are broken, but I can dump some weight. I've got a heck of a lot of fiber. Trying to think what would be most beneficial right now. I'm going to need that for the raft. But the rest, I think I'll just keep the points for the time being. Now, if you've never played Ark before, if you're a first timer, then once you've learned how to make spark powder. That is a very, very effective way of earning XP in the low levels of the game. With flint and stone in the mortar and pestle, I can actually grind these together to make spark powder. And spark powder you use as fuel for fires and furnaces, and you can also use it to make jerky, cooked meat jerky. What weight can I dump? I don't need that. Try and stick the keratin in there because that's worth keeping hold of. I don't need quite as much fiber as I've got. That should be fine. Right, let's see if there's another parasaur around yet. Can't see one that way. I'll take the narcotics with me just in case I do see one along that direction. But now I've got a decent supply of food and 3 water skins full of water. I feel a bit more confident to face what's happening. More combis. And I haven't equipped the spear. Let's just sort that out. Get a bit of distance. And hope the spear doesn't break. Those split up. There's a parasol. There's also a Lystrosaurus. Two of them, in fact. There we go. I wonder what level this one is. That might not take long to knock out. Go. Sorry about this, but I want you to be mine. To sleep, please. There we go. And I'll stick some of those in and some of those and see how it goes. Talking of weapons, I should be able. Oh, wow, that was quick. I should be able to make a bow. Just check. What do I need for that? Wood. And what do I need to repair that? Wood. And what's that on the floor? Wood. Oh, compete. Some more fight, hide and meat. Not sure where the other compi was. But yeah, oh, that's fine. I'm going to need more thatch, more flint for that. But yeah, making progress. So let me just check the saddles. Just more wood, and there's a tree over there. Well, actually, there's downed wood, dead wood here, driftwood. I'll use that rather than cut down a perfectly good tree. Saddle. I'll best take that back. And we eat a couple of berries. And now, oh, I'm still 1 level short. But what can I learn at level 15? Hide pants and hide shirt. Can I actually make those? Do I have enough? Oh, I'm going to need the hide for the raft, actually. Now I think of it. I'll quickly put some of the weight I've got into there. But now I have a ride. Just use the opportunity to get the accuracy right to harvest a little fruit berries. Harvest some berries. There we go. I'll just grab the narco berries out of this chap. Chapess, as it turns out to be. And I can make another 31 narcotics. Not too shabby. I do have a lot of meat on me. It may be worth taming one of those pteranodons just to use the meat. Oh, that's broken. I'll need some wood from him. No, it's not. Crafting another one. Need to put that wood back in the parasol. So, hopefully can knock out one of these. Let's see what level this is. Forty-eight. I'll give it a go. There's only two potential outcomes. Well, three if something comes along and kills me while I'm in the process of taming, but yeah, I can either knock this out or fail. And we have success. So yeah, I can stick this meat on there and reduce my carrying, or increase my carrying capacity substantially. I don't have to worry now about running back and feeding it every couple of minutes. I just have to keep an eye on the torpidity. It is going down a bit, so I'll just quickly give it some narcotics and there we go. Now I should be able to learn the raft. Do I have enough points? Yes, I do. I need fiber wooden hide. And I'm going to need more wood. Oh, there was some right behind me. And some here as well, so that'll be helpful. Just whistle stop on him or her, sorry. So this she doesn't go too far away. Hopefully that's enough to make the raft. Have they moved it? Wood. Just throw this down so I can get close enough to put it in a parcel. Into the parcel. Actually, can I just hop up? Best just quickly check this. The time. That's doing nicely. Another shot of narcotics. I don't think it'll need any more. If it tames that, doesn't lose taming effectiveness, that should gain 23 levels. Probably going to need thatch as well. So how much have we got in here? I'm still short of maybe 30 wood. This driftwood log is right next to the water, so can't quite reach the power cell from there. More than enough wood for the job. This does weigh 85 pounds, the raft does, so once I've used this wood, that'll be a it'll replace one heavy weight for another. Can I move? No, I can't. Let's just quickly stick things into the parasol that way. Oh, I still can't move. Let's just add some weight carrying capacity, that might help. And the rest, the other one on fortitude. I learned the Chankaro yet. No, it's level 21. Right. Preserving bin will be useful. And large storage box. So let's see, yeah, launch that properly. I get that and make up some thatch platform, thatch foundations. And then the rest I'll make into ceilings. Luckily, I should get quite a few points out of this. XP points for all the crafting required. That there. So now I've got the general dimensions sorted. I could do with more wood and more thatch. This is going to take some time, so when I've completed the raft, I'll bring you back in. Right, I'm back. I've been building the raft and getting bows and arrows and that sort of thing sorted out. But I came out to grab some more fiber and thatch and just came it up the hill a little bit from the beach where I was at. And yeah, just thought I'd show you around. There you go. It's a very nice looking setting. What the picture doesn't well what the image belies is the fact that it is really quite cold, and it's only because I've been pumping up my fortitude that you don't see the snowflake symbol in the bottom corner of the screen. But yes, it's very nice to look at, but it's very, very cold. There's a lighthouse up in the distance. When I get up to a level where I can learn how to make a saddle for my Pteranodon, I do want to go and have a quick exploration of that before I move off anywhere. But yeah, I'm just making my way back to the rafty, as you can see in the distance. The parasaur is level, is it 28 now? Yeah, level 28. So I've put some points into the weight carrying capacity, and that's about it at the moment. But once I'm happy with the weight carrying capacity, I will be building up stamina, movement speed, and health, and possibly even melee damage, because if you put points into melee, it improves harvesting capabilities, or how much they gather. So that's what I might do. But yeah, so far this is the raft. It is not complete yet. I just wanted to get the basic structured floor plan down and add beds so I can go to sleep. But yeah, Pteranodon level 74 now. So I've been steadily working on the weight carrying capacity there as well. Anything going on here? No, I've made. I learned how to make trank arrows, so I now have 31 trank arrows available, which will really help in taming the scarier things like trying to take on a trike. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that. It will not be in this episode. I have to get more narcotics ready and get myself ready before tackling that. But yeah, I could do with the hide to make the saddles for the Pteranodon, wherever that was. Yes, over here. But yeah, for now, I'm just sort that out. I am a Malwa Skyboy. Thanks for watching. Until next time, happy trails.